Hey there, I'm Benjamin from Loves Data. In this video, you're going to learn how to add a pivot table to your Google Data Studio report. Adding a pivot table allows to add multiple dimensions for a more granular view of your data. In this video, we're going to look at an example of using a pivot table to understand the performance of our marketing channels and landing pages using data from Google Analytics. Let's get started. I've already added the sample Google Analytics data source to this report. But if you're new to Google Data Studio, you might want to watch my in-depth tutorials which walk through creating dashboards from scratch. You can find the links to these videos in the description below. Let's select Pivot Table and add the pivot table to our report. You can now modify the dimensions and metrics that are included in the pivot table. We can see that by default we have the medium running across the top of the pivot table and source as the column on the left. We're going to use the pivot table to understand how our landing pages perform based on the different marketing channels that people are using to find them. Let's start by changing the row dimension from medium to default channel grouping. This allows us to see a top-level view of our different marketing channels. Now let's change the column dimension from source to landing page. Now we can see the number of sessions broken down by the two dimensions. This allows us to identify the landing pages that are seeing the most traffic from the different channels. Now let's change the metric. I'm going to change the metric to Smart Goal Completions for this example, since we're using sample data from Google's merchandise store. But I encourage you to try different metrics like revenue, other conversion metrics, and even engagement metrics like bounce rate. To make the report easier to interpret, we can also add a heat map for the metrics. To do this, we select the Style tab and then look for Number under Metric. Let's click this and change it to Heat Map. Now we can quickly see that referrals to the homepage have the highest number of Smart Goal conversions, but we can also identify other landing pages that appear to perform well for other marketing channels, like the third landing page here, which is for YouTube products. This has resulted in a good number of conversions. So that's how we can add a pivot table to our report. You'll notice at the top of the report, the pivot table icon has been grayed out. This is because we can only add one pivot table per page. So if you want to use another pivot table, all we need to do is add an extra page to the report. And here's a quick tip. Try adding a filter to control your report. This allows you to make the report more dynamic and focus on particular sections of your traffic. For example, we can select Filter Control and add it to our report. Then we can select User Type. And now when we view the report, we can choose if we want to just see new or returning users. When we select one of the options, the pivot table updates. So if you haven't already, then head to Google Data Studio and add a pivot table to your report. It's a great way to include more granular detail in your report, as we've seen in this example. You can also select additional metrics to add to your table. You might find that Google Data Studio tells you there is too much data to present. So if you do see this message, you can try changing the dimensions, adding a filter, or applying a segment to your pivot table. Are you using pivot tables in Google Data Studio? I'd love to know. Share your tips in the comments below. And if you found this video helpful, then please like it so I know to make more videos like this. See you next time.